On the second match day, we witnessed many strong and entertaining performances from the clubs, whether it is the comeback of Northeast United or Odisha, from going 2-0 down in the first half to finish the match at 2-2 each against Kerala Blasters and Jamshedpur respectively. Also, we witnessed the first ever Kolkata Derby in the Indian Super League, which ended in ATK Mohun Bagan's favour. So here we present the starting 11 and some substitutes according to their performances in the match day 2. In between sticks, we saw two fantastic performances from both our national team goalkeepers, Gurpreet Singh and Amrinder Singh. Both made an excellent save, which helped them to keep a clean sheet. But by just margin, we choose Amrinder Singh in our lineup, who helped his team to secure 3 points with his stunning saves against FC Goa. He finished the match with 31 touches, 3 saves and a passing accuracy of 83%. In front of the goalkeeper, we saw a solid defensive performance from Pritam Kotal in the Kolkata Derby, but there was another player who outperformed him, the new signing from Jamshedpur FC, Terry. Although East Bengal displayed good possession-based football and dominated in the midfield, but in the final third, ATK Mohun Bagan's defenders defended well and Terry played a crucial role in keeping the clean sheet. He made 7 clearances as well as 2 tackles and won 4 defensive duels out of 5. Also, he never dribbled past throughout the 90 minutes. So our first centre-back made into the team is Terry and Pritam Kotal made into substitutes. Our second centre-back is from Hyderabad FC, Chingal Sana Singh, whose first match of ISL 7 was simply brilliant. He pocketed Crystal Offset so much so that the Bengaluru striker only lasted the one half while also making 3 interceptions and 7 clearances. In building up the attack from the back, his passing was accurate. He made 67 passes with 91% success. Another Hyderabad FC defender in our team of the week is right-back Ashish Rai, who kept Indian team's keeper Sunil Chhetri quiet throughout the 90 minutes. In going forward, he made underlapping and overlapping runs and provided 3 crosses in the box and was always available on the right side as a passing option. The only representation of Northeast United in our team of the week comes courtesy of Gurjinder Kumar, who was superb on the left side of the defense. He kept Satyansen Singh in check against Kerala Blasters while also getting 81 touches on the ball, maintaining a pass completion rate of 85% and winning 8 out of 11 defensive duels. Also, he completed 12 long passes out of 15, one of which served as an assist for the last gap's equalizer. In the middle, our first pick is Kerala Blasters captain Sergio Sidonicha. He was quite brilliant against Northeast United as he boosted proceeding in the midfield from his side. To add to that, he scored the opener with a perfectly guided header into the top of the corner. Besides that, he had a pass completion rate of 81% and completed 3 out of 3 long balls. In defense, he won 5 out of 6 defensive duels. Our second midfielder is the young Indian prospect from Bengaluru FC, Suresh Vanjam Singh. His work rate against Hyderabad was outstanding. The 20-year-old helped his team in attack as well as in defense. Although the game between Bengaluru and Hyderabad ended in a goalless draw, this young lad was worth to watch. The third midfielder is the only man in our lineup who ended up in the losing side of his match is Alberto Nogueira. So that should speak volume of his performance. The Spaniard keeps the ball moving in the midfield and created some chances for the striker, and he managed 62 touches and an excellent pass completion rate of 92%. Because of the red card to Nadeem Talang in the 40th minute, he contributed in defense as well, won 9 out of 49 duels and 4 tackles and interceptions in a battling display as he tried to inject some defensive solidity and creativity into his numerically depleted side. Moving on to wingers, the second Mumbai City player in our list is C.Y. Goddard, who impressed once again versus Goa, even in the first half when most of his teammates were rather poor. He brightened up even more in the second half, ended up providing the cross which led to the match-winning penalty. He also created a lot of difficulties to Goa's defense with his dribbling skills, as he made 5 successful dribbles out of 8. In addition to that, he made 12 crosses and provided 4 key passes. The Japanese winger is performing well for Mumbai City and is definitely a player to watch this season. In the left wing position, Diego Mauricio made in our lineup because of his excellent performance against Jamshedpur. His exploits salvaged a point for his side, which he kept up in some style with an absolute thunderbolt of a finish in the 3rd minute of the stoppage time. The Brazilian forward finished the match with a couple of goals from 6 shots, which made up nearly half of his touches in an ultra-efficient display. At the striker position, we saw Roy Krishna made history by scoring the first ever goal for ATK Mohun Bagan in the Kolkata Derby in ISL, and also witnessed Adam Lefondra's first goal in the ISL from penalty. But the person who made into the lineup is none other than the last year's Golden Boot winner, Narijus Valskis. He has been adapting to life brilliantly in a new surroundings in Jamshedpur, as he bagged a brilliant first half brace against Odisha with a calm penalty and clinical first time finish to put his side 2 goals up before the half hour mark. The Lithuanian international attempted 4 shots, out of which 2 were on target, won 12 out of 16 duels, and had a passing accuracy of 64%, which is good for strikers as they made more riskier passes in the final third. This is our starting 11 and substitutes for match day 2. This video came in collaboration with letsfootballin.com. To read more analytical articles about Indian football, please visit letsfootballin.com. The link is in the description below. Thanks for watching the video, and if you like our content, then please subscribe to our channel and turn on the notification bell to support the channel. And also follow us on Instagram. The link is in the description below.